Now, my final question would be about the case of Apollo Quiboloy. Kasi sa FBI, sa US, wanted siya for sex trafficking by force, fraud, and coercion, sex trafficking of children, conspiracy, and bulk cash smuggling. So, gusto kong magtanong kung may idea po ba yung DFA, bakit hanggang ngayon wala pa rin yung extradition request galing sa US? Kasi may kaso na siya eh. At kung gusto talaga nilang maaresto siya, based on the PH-US extradition treaty, dapat sila yung mag-send ng request na yun sa atin. So, ano po yung update doon?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I request Yusek De Vega?
Yusek De Vega, you're recognized. Salamat po. Tama po kayo. Dapat sa Philippine-US Extradition Treaty, silang una mag-request. Pero, and I, we have the ASEC for Legal Affairs as well here. As of now, we don't have the request. And hindi rin natin gagawin na tayo magsasabi sa US request.
Yeah.
Request the extradition of one of our citizens. So, in fact, that is one reason under the extradition treaty with the US and other extradition treaties to deny a request. If it's your own citizen that you will send to the other country, you have the option to deny it, to deny that request. But of course, wala pang request. So, yeah. We'll see.
Kasi yan, nagtataka din tayo, this has already dragged on for months. Tapos kung seryoso din yung US na i-hold accountable si Apollo Quiboloy, dapat nagpadala na siya ng request. In line with that, no, gusto kong malaman din mula sa DFA kasi nagbabanta din si Apollo Quiboloy. To quote, ito sabi niya nung November, yung persecution daw sa kanya will lead to diseases worse than Omicron. Tapos to quote, kung gusto daw nating matigil yung pandemya, itigil natin yung persecution sa kanya. So, gusto ko lang malaman, does this affect the position of DFA? Natatakot ba kayo sa ganong threat?
Anyone from the DFA?
Sir, we cannot speak for Pastor Quiboloy, no? But
are you threatened? Kasi daw, ganun eh, lalala yung pandemya if anyone will act on this case. And that includes the DFA.
Filipino Foreign Service officers are always brave to challenge, to respond to any challenge. We're not afraid.
Okay, I'm pleased to hear that. Kasi actually, kung papakinggan nga yun, diba, yung sinabi na yun, it sounds like a joke, but it's not a joke for him. Seryoso siya doon. Kaya at least panatag ako na marinig yun sa ating DFA na hindi sila natatakot sa ganong banda.
But if I may, Your Honor, no? Kasi po, the DFA is just like, ang role namin sa extradition is like, what do you say? I don't want to say post office, no? It's the DOJ which processes these requests. Tapos dadampa yan sa court, sa RTC, to process it. And we're the ones who pass it on, no? So we're not, anyway. Basta, when it comes, sir, yeah, we'll certainly update you on it.
Yeah, at least gagampanan nyo kung ano man yung papel nyo in line dun sa proseso. Yes, that would be all, Madam, Mr. Chair. Maraming salamat.
Thank you very much, Representative Manuel.